So, this morning I'm going to speak to you about regaining your divine capacity. Divine capacity. A couple of weeks ago, in the middle of October, towards the end of October, it was quite dry and some very hot days. And I could see that our trees and the lawn was really taking a beating from the sun. It was hot. And at that time, our pump, we've got a borehole here, big one, and it started giving problems. It was not giving enough water. And so the guys came, Thomas and Jaku and Gerard, and they pulled it out. They pulled the pump out. And they found out what the problem was, right? Just when the water water comes out of the pump, there was like a break. And the water was pumping back into the hole. So they fixed that up. And then Thomas said, you know what? This is such a big pump. It's a huge pump. It's about this big. And, he started thinking, because we were not getting enough water. The sprays were running, but not as strong. He said, there's something wrong. And then he went into it and he discovered that when they put in the pump a couple of years ago, they just connected right up to the old pipes. And the old pipes were very, still thin and so on. And so when they put the pump back on, there were some pipes that ruptured and so on. And he came and spoke to me and said, Pastor, I think we need to replace all these pipes and loosen up this pump, because this pump is choked. It's choked. So the capacity of the pump was 7,000 liters or something per hour, and we're not getting that water through. So they started working, replaced the pipes and so on, and one day they were finished, and he called me, he said, come and look here, come and see here. And he was so excited, and he was inviting everybody to come and look, and those sprayers were going like this, and it was like just water, just spraying water. All of a sudden, can you just think about this? I spent the money, many years ago, it's quite some time ago, at least 5-6 years ago, to put in that big pump, because we've got a good borehole, and we were not getting the full capacity of the water, the full capacity of the pump. And the trees and the lawn are suffering because of that, and especially now with the heat waves that we're getting. But now it was released. The capacity of the pump was released, and it's fixed up. So we've got all this water. Now that I started thinking about us and our capacity. Because let me tell you something, the world is waiting for the church to come to its full capacity. The world is in trouble. Can you say amen? The world is in desperate trouble. I think Bill Hybels says that the hope of the church is leadership. But the hope for the world is the church. The church needs to rise up. The church needs to come to its full capacity, so that the world can be saved by Jesus. Can you say amen? Amen. And I'm not speaking just about pastors and ministers. I'm speaking about the whole body of Christ is going to have to come to its full capacity to reach the nations with the healing power of the Lord Jesus Christ. To reach the nations with the love of God. Amen. Because the world is dying. There's so much hatred in the world. The world is crying out, save us. Is there somebody out there that can save us? And here, I'm telling you, we don't know the capacity of the church of God. There's a huge capacity that must be released in the world. Amen. So this morning, I'm going to speak to you about regaining your divine capacity. Won't you just say to somebody, your neighbor next to you, you have got a divine capacity. It might be choked up. It might be blocked up, but it's there. And now you look at that picture there, and I want you to say to your neighbor, that is you. When you were in your mother's womb, that is you in the beginning. And I'm going to read to you a scripture this morning, because I want the word of God to fall into your heart. You need to receive the word of God like seeds going into your heart, into your soul. Implanted seeds that will bring life and change and set you free and bring the release the capacity of God that's in your soul. Amen. So I'm speaking, I'm preaching to your soul this morning. You know that you are a spirit, you have a soul, and you live in a body. You are a triune being, spirit, soul, and body. And you cannot separate. We cannot separate spirit, soul, and body. Only God can do that. Amen. So we are a unity, but I'm focusing this morning. So you need to look from my perspective. I'm ministering to your soul. I'm not ministering so much to your spirit, because your spirit is the source, but your soul is the channel. Like the borehole, the borehole is the source of all the water, but the pump is like the channel. The pump pumps through. Can you say amen? Right. So just think of that. Now, pay attention now, because I'm going to read you a scripture. I'm going to give you the word to let you see this morning how God sees you and what is in the mind of God right in the beginning when He formed you. Here in the book of Psalms 139 verse 13, I'm reading here from the New Living Translation. You made all the delicate inner parts of my body and knit me together in my mother's womb. Thank you for making me so wonderfully complex. Your workmanship is marvelous. How well I know it. You watched me as I was being formed in the utter seclusion, as I was woven together in the dark of the womb. You saw me before I was born. Every day of my life was recorded in your book. Every moment was laid out before a single day had passed. This is right in the beginning. I know some things happened in between. I know. But I'm taking you back to the beginning. I'm taking you back to the Lord. Are you with me here this morning? You were created. Now look at that picture there. Isn't that beautiful? That big hand with that heart there. You were created by love. You were created for love. And you were created to love. Your origin. Your beginning. Your source was love. And I'm not speaking about this morning human love. I'm speaking about the love of God. Your very, very beginning, your origin, where you came from, your source that produced you, that worked upon you, that created you, that formed you, that shaped you, was love, the love of God. You were created by divine love. You were wonderfully made by love. You see, when you think about God, what do you think about God? When you think about God, you must understand something. God is love. God is love. And I don't want you just to say that or think that just superficially. You need to think more. You need to think deeper about that. God is love. There's no hatred in God. There's no imperfection in love. When you were formed, when you, right in the beginning, in the mind of God, when He planned you, when He purposed you, when He saw you, He formed and He shaped you out of His love. His love, His divine love, out of perfection. So your origin, your beginning was perfection. To be the perfect love of God. That is where you came from. That is your beginning. Can you say amen here this morning? And the word says here that God made you wonderfully. He formed you. He knitted you together. You were wonderfully made by love. You were purposefully formed by love. When God formed you, when He shaped you, He thought about you. He thought about the color of your eyes. He thought about the color of your hair. He thought about everything, the shape, your shape, everything. Your personality. It wasn't just something small. It was something big. Because God purposefully shaped you. He purposefully made you. He purposefully created you. He purposefully formed you from His love. Because God is love. I just want you to think about that. And you need to go and meditate on that. You need to get into your room and read the scripture and ask the Holy Spirit to give you something, to show you, almost experiencing when God formed you and He thought about you. Now you must think about this. When God formed you, when He shaped you, there was nothing evil, nothing bad, no rejection in you, nothing. You were shaped and formed out of perfection. You were shaped and formed out of perfect love. I know when you look at yourself today, you are far from it. You say, Pastor, I'm far from it. Yes, I know. We are all far from that because something happened in between. We know that Adam sinned. We know we fell into sin and God's plan, purpose, and things were messed up in our lives. We know that. But that doesn't change it because you are still God's creation. Can you say amen? God is going to. Listen, God never leaves. He never stops working in our lives. Amen. So I need you to get this morning. Your origin, it's almost like roots of a tree. If the roots of a tree are strong and good, the tree will be strong and good, and the tree will bear much fruit. Can you say amen? It's like if the roots of a tree are like with a lot of water, that tree will flourish because there's water there. Can you say amen? It will just... If it's close to a well or a fountain, those roots will go down deep and they'll go and get the water out, and it will flourish. It's like that. I want you to understand that your origin, your beginning was in perfect love. And in that love, there's no imperfection. Yes, the devil messed you up. The devil messed us up. The devil came into our DNA. He brought in sickness. He brought in sin and death. And destruction. But let me tell you this morning, this is not how it's going to end. Praise God. There's a hopeful future for God's people. Amen. That's why we are believers. Here in the book of 1 John 4 verse 16 we read, "And we have known and believed the love that God has for us. God is love. And he who abides in love abides in God and God in him." God is love. Won't you say that with me? God is love. God is love. Number two, you were created for love. You were created, number one, you were created by love. Number two, you were created for love. Your greatest joy is to be loved. Have you ever noticed when young people when they fall in love? How they blossom. Can you remember how you blossomed when you were young and you fell in love and you felt so loved by your boyfriend or by your girlfriend? It's like you blossom. Why? Because your greatest joy is to be loved. Your greatest joy is to receive love. Love brings joy in your life. Can you say amen? Amen. You were created for love. You were created. Not just by love. You were created for love. You need love. Your soul needs love. Your soul needs love. You were knitted together by God to be loved. Your life is not an island. You know what an island is? Some place out there in the ocean. Nobody ever comes there. A place of loneliness, a place of isolation. Listen, that place of isolation brings death. That is not what God had in mind. God, when He made you, He created you for love. He created you to be connected to other people, to receive love from other people, to receive love from a wife, to receive love from your children or a husband, to receive love from the body of Christ. He created you for love. Can you say amen? I think the most terrible thing about hell is there's no love. Forever and ever and ever and ever, there's no love. There's nobody there that will come and touch you. There's nobody there that will ever express love to you in hell. It must be the most, for me, I think hell, the most terrible thing of hell will be there's no love. We'll never ever feel love, sense love. Love is so important for us. Without love, you wither away. Your life falls apart. Why? Because God made you for love. He created you for love. He shaped your soul to be loved. Your soul needs love. You know, the story in Matthew 8 where Jesus healed the leper. I can picture it in my mind. When I read the Bible, I like to picture it, especially what Jesus did, His miracles, the Gospels. I like to picture it. I paint a picture for myself. And I try to experience it, to experience, and ask the Holy Spirit to help me. Because, you know, when you're busy with the Word of God, you can easily become a Pharisee, a scribe. You can receive the letter, but not the spirit of the Word of God. So I want to challenge you there. Whenever you read the Word of God, don't just superficially read, but experience it. Try and see it. Picture it. Use your imagination. Ask the Holy Spirit to bring you into that situation. And, you know, when I picture this, I can see the picture, because I was in Israel, in Jerusalem, in 2007. We visited there, and I've got some idea about this. And in my mind, the people that became leprous, they were rejected by the other people. The other people were scared. They were afraid of them, because leprosy was seen as a disease that was transmitted across. It was transferable. So people were afraid. When a leper came in his direction, they would back off. They would not come close to a leper, because leprosy was such a terrible disease that people would be eaten up by leprosy. Today we know much more about leprosy. And those people, they went away from the cities. They went away from the other people. And they went to live in isolation, in like, you know, dark places, in caves and things like that, separated from other people, without love, without somebody ever touching them. Listen, love is more than just the words. Love is also touching. Can you say amen? When I touch Corey here now, it's love. When I touch him, just touch him, it's love. God created you, even your body. He created your body just to be touched. You know, when I picture this, Jesus came to this man, the one who formed him, the one who shaped him in his mother's womb. And he went searching for him. And he found him outside the city. And when this man saw Jesus, he was standing distance away, and he was saying, Jesus, if you want to, you can heal me. And I think in my mind's eye, I can picture Jesus not saying anything, but walking right up to him, watching him in his eyes, and you know, creating this expectation, coming closer and closer to Him. The creator of His soul was there with Him. And then, without saying anything immediately, stretching out His hand, just touching Him. Just think about, maybe this man, for many years, nobody has ever touched Him. Nobody has ever hugged Him. Nobody has ever shaken His hand. And here comes Jesus, touched Him. And all Jesus said, I want to be healed. And the Bible says at that moment, He was healed. What happened? He received love. He was touched by love. See, the Bible says here in Matthew 8 verse 3, then Jesus put His hand out and touched Him, saying, I'm willing, be cleansed. Immediately, His leprosy was cleansed. I tell you, the world is full of leprosy. The world needs the touch of Jesus. Can you say amen? The world needs the healing touch of Jesus. The world is desperate for love. The love of Jesus. You were not only created for love, but you were created to love. You were created by love. You were created for love, but you were also created to love. You were created with a capacity. You were given a capacity to love. God has given you that capacity, like that pump has got a capacity to pump so much water. So you have got a capacity to let your love flow, because you're not like a stagnant thing. You are like a living stream of water. Can you say amen? You were shaped and formed to love. When God shaped you, when love shaped you in His mind, He also shaped you. One day you will be somebody that through you will flow His river of love. One that inside of you, you've got the river of love. Inside of you, you've got the living streams of life. Inside of you, you've got wells of refreshing. It's inside of you. The capacity is there. That is your divine capacity that God has given you. Say, Pastor, but I don't see it in my life and I struggle with that. I know we do. That's why the message is regaining your capacity. Getting your capacity back. Because something has happened. The enemy has come and he's choked up. He has blocked up. He has clogged up your capacity. He has cut off your capacity of love, to receive love and to show love and to flow in love. But the Lord God who made you wants that capacity to be released so that there will be water on earth. Can you say amen? See, so here in the book of 1 John 4 verse 7, beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God, and everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. See, love. You know when you are in the presence of love. Love doesn't want, if you are in the presence of love, if you experience love, you don't want to leave. You want to stay there. When you feel loved, you want to stay there. Can you say amen? Are you like that as well? I want to be where I'm loved. I like to be where I'm loved. Because that is how God made us. He made us to be loved. And when you experience love, when you feel love, it brings joy. It brings fulfillment in your life. It makes you to blossom. Amen. Now, in the book of Genesis, we have a very interesting story where Isaac, that means laughter. Now, there's a key, laughter. Isaac, that means laughter. He would go around. He was like his father Abraham. And his father Abraham, when he was young, he was a man of faith. And Abraham is a type of our faith life as well. He was not, he was like a, what do you call these guys? I had the word in Afrikaans, now I forgot it in English. He was like a nomad, that's it. He was like a nomad. He had a tent. And they lived in the desert in those days. There were not real cities and so on. So Abraham would move and he would take his tent and go to another place. If it became too dry where he was. And then what he would do, when he got to a place, he would dig a new well. He would look for water. He would dig a well, open up a well, got water. And he would stay there. And so he would go around, you know, as a nomad, taking his sheep and whatever his animals to where there was grazing for them. And wherever he came, he dug a well of water. Who knows? Water is life. Amen. Water is life. So, after he'd gone on to be the Lord with the Lord, Isaac came. Isaac, the son of Abraham. And what happened? The Philistines had filled up all these wells with rocks and dust and junk and so on. Isaac would come and he would redig the wells. He would take out all the junk. He would clear up the wells. Amen. That's what he would do. Now, this is speaking about you and me. Because really, your faith life, this is the thing. Your faith life, your faith battle is to re-dig open your wells, to regain your capacity. Can you say amen? To open up what the devil has blocked up through rejection, through pain, through shame, through everything, how the devil has blocked up, clogged up, and choked up your capacity. Your faith struggle, your faith life, your faith battle is to reopen those wells, to unblock the streams of life, to regain your love capacity. The question is it possible? Is it possible? Well, Jesus said, everything is possible for him who can believe. All things are possible for them who can believe. And let me encourage you this morning. I don't want to discourage you. I want to give you courage. There is hope. Say to somebody next to you, there is hope. You are not alone. You've got a helper. You've got somebody that God has sent to help you to do that, to regain your capacity. Who is that person? It's the Holy Spirit in Romans 5 verse 5. And this hope will never disappoint us. We know this because God has poured out His love to fill our hearts through the Holy Spirit He gave us. Let me tell you something. God is moving forward with you. God is taking you to a place where you are going to be full of the Holy Spirit. Spirit, soul, and body. The love of God is just going to ooze out of you. The streams of life is just going to flow through you in full capacity. God is busy with you through the help of the Holy Spirit, cleaning up your soul, flushing out all the dirt of the devil, whatever he put in there to block you up. Not far in the distant future, he's going to be finished. The Holy Spirit is going to be finished. And He's going to turn open all the fountains and streams of His love. Can you say amen? Now, how great is your capacity? I'm going to close here. How great is your capacity? One day Jesus went out and He visited a man that was living also way out of the city. As a matter of fact, he was chased out. He was chained up. He couldn't live amongst normal people. He was so demonized, he became totally insane. His total capacity was blocked up by 1,000 demons. He was a madman. He was scratching himself with stones. He was hurting himself. He was a danger to society. He was a killer. If he found you, he would rip you apart. He was full of demons. There was no hope for him. He was beyond repair. It was beyond recover. There was no hope for this man. He had no family left. He had no loved ones left. He was all by himself among the graves because he was totally demonized. Probably the worst person ever in the history of mankind. I believe it's in the Bible to give us hope. Because for God, nothing is impossible. God can rescue any person. The love of Jesus can save every person. The love of Jesus can restore the capacity of any person. Doesn't matter how powerful the devil got hold of his life. And Jesus went out to him. And it took, just think about this. How great is that capacity? How great is your capacity? Just think about this. It took 1,000 demons to block up his capacity. Not one demon, not two demons. 1,000 demons to block up his soul. His capacity was completely blocked up by demons. So how great is his capacity? How great is your capacity? Just think about this. Think about this. And Jesus came, the love of Christ, unblocked him. The love of Christ flushed out the legion of demons. The love of Christ came to him like a river, flushing out all those demons, sending them into the pigs. And the Bible says that when his disciples found them, this man was clothed. He was all by himself. He was back to his normal mind. He was totally healed. Wow. By the love of Jesus. Amen. Let's give God the praise offering here. Now let me tell you something here this morning. What is your capacity? How great is your capacity? Your capacity is equal to the love of Christ. That is your full capacity is the love of Christ. The love of Jesus. We are like that pump. There's a source, the river of love. And when we get born again, we get born into that river of love. Just think about that. We get born into that river of love. All we need to do is to get unblocked and start pumping the love of God. Pumping to our full capacity, full capacity. How great is that? Have the love of Jesus. Now listen, you're going to find out. In the end times, you'll find out. Because God will reveal it in the end times. It's coming. Here in Ephesians 3 verse 8, an apostle Paul prayed for this. And I believe it's going to happen. There are some marvelous things happening and going to happen in the church in the end times. Where God brings unity in the body of Christ. Where God brings total healing, total restoration. We are now already into the year 5778 on the Jewish calendar. We are coming out of an old season. We're coming out of a season that things have been completed. We are moving into a season of covenant. Come on, covenant, covenant, covenant. When God made a covenant with Abraham, he took that animal and he cut it in half and he put one part here and he put another part there. And when the sun went down, he put Abraham to sleep. And then God came like a furnace. He went through those two pieces of meat. In a figure eight, and he was saying, I'm making an everlasting covenant. I am making an everlasting covenant. And you know, that eight means it's never going to end. It's never going to be complete. We are moving into 2018. But we are already, as children of God, in the year 5778. There are new things beginning. Listen, many of you, new things will be born now. New things will begin to happen in your life. Old things are gone. Many of us, we were at an end of a season. And I'm speaking about relationships and things like that. There are people that have left our lives. Because, you know, some people are with you short term. Some people are with you medium term. Some people are with you long term. Now, as God moves you on, some people will be taken out because they are not part of your new season. As a matter of fact, they will hold you back. They will keep you out of your new season. So when God has moved you and He's left some people behind, you must realize that they are not going to go with you. God is taking you. God will bring new people into your life. He will connect you with new people, and they will help you in this season, the new season that is coming. And new things will begin to unfold in your life. Amen. Because God will finish His work. Won't you say to somebody, God will finish His work. He will bring you to your full capacity. Amen. He's going to bring you to your full capacity. So the Apostle Paul prayed for us through the Holy Spirit. He prayed. He said this prayer. And I want you to pray this prayer for yourself. He said, and I pray that you and all God's holy people will have the power to understand the greatness of Christ's love. How wide. What he's saying here, I want you to understand the capacity of Christ's love. He's speaking about the dimensions of Christ's love. How wide, how long, how high, and how deep that love is. Listen, this love of Jesus is unfathomable. It cannot even be measured. Can you try to think how great the love of Jesus is? Listen, to die on the cross for us, to show the love of Christ, and even forgiving us, taking our sins upon Him. How great is this love? How great is this love to forgive your enemies who nailed you to the cross, the enemies of your life? Is this love? Won't you stand with me?